You're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio.
Hey, this is Jermaine Robbins, and you're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio.
This is Shay Solwright, and you're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way that you, I, and we listen to radio.
This is Tahira Memory, and you're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio.
What's going on, guys? It's your girl, Wyan Solo. You better turn that speaker up to the max, because you're listening to iLive Radio.
iLive Radio.
iLive Radio.
iLive Radio.
iLive Radio.
iLive UK and Independent Hype, in conjunction with Groundbreaking, presents Soulfest Lounge UK on Thursday, the 26th of September, 2019. This will be one night where you get given the soul, the whole soul, and nothing but the soul. The Hideaway opens its doors to UK's independent recording artist, Shayla Prosper, and from Toronto, Canada, Ray Robinson. This night will be hosted by Shaq D from My Soul. Your music entertainment will be selected by DJs from Solar Radio, Radio, Raw Soul Radio Live, and Starpoint. Doors open at 7 p.m. Showtime 8 p.m. Tickets available from allthew.hideawaylive.co.uk. Soulfest Lounge UK at The Hideaway, 2 Empire Muse, London, SW16 2BF. See you there.
Join the Music Collective family every Sunday for the Sunday Vibe from 12 till 4 on iLive Radio. The best in quality music, special theme shows quarterly, and the infamous end of the month show, when the Music Collective family get together for fun and frolics. So don't miss out on your Sunday Vibe on iLive Radio via the TuneIn app or the iLive mobile app. See you Sunday.
Music Collective Sunday Vibe on iLive Radio.
Taxman here. I invite you to join me each and every Thursday between the hours of 5 and 7 p.m. right here on iLive Radio, where we give you the very best in independent and neo-soul flavors. We also feature the UK Top 20 Independent Soul Chart, counting you down from number 20 all the way down to number 1. Why not check us out every Thursday between the hours of 5 to 7 right here on iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to music.
Hey, hey, hello and welcome. It's your girl Claude, aka Miss Alge, right here on iLive UK. Be sure to tune into my shows each and every Saturday between the hours of 6 and 8 p.m. My shows are called The Independent Injection, because you can expect to hear deep and meaningful, fresh neo and bassline soul, slow jams and gospel, mixed with a little bit of nostalgia. I look forward to seeing you then.
Ready to start your Saturday night? Tune in to the Beats and Bass Show here on iLive Radio with me, DJ Deep Sound. Delve into the sounds of 140, deep dubstep, drum and bass, house, and many genres. Spinning something different every week, featuring special guest DJs and artists. The Beats and Bass Show, weekly, 2 to 4 p.m. UK time, here on iLive Radio. Be there or be square.
What's up, London? This is the Ladies' Choice, DJ Mixmaster Caesar, coming to you straight from the 6 with the Red Planet Mix Show. Every Saturdays, 10 p.m. until midnight, spinning in the best music in hip-hop, R&B, soca, reggae, and top 40, exclusively on iLive UK, changing the way you listen to radio.
You're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio. iLive Radio.
Live sounds. Look out. Here we go.
Now tuned into the greatest.
This bloke is one angry, naughty, aggressive crocodile.
Look at that, real you. They should know.
Real DGM.
Don't just come up here and play tune and press buttons.
Real DGM.
Saturday Soup on iLive Radio. All the organic goodness you need. Everybody needs some Saturday Soup.
comprehend the guidelines. My chest out, chinchilla all relaxed on the sidelines. I'm so famous, understand. New York City respect my game like Joe Nick. Comprehend the guidelines. My chest out, chinchilla all relaxed on the comprehend the guidelines. My chest out, chinchilla all relaxed on the comprehend the guidelines. My chest out, chinchilla all relaxed on the sidelines. I'm so famous, understand. New York City respect my game like Joe Namath. And I protect my name like Joe Anus. In prison, y'all don't hear me, y'all don't listen. Y'all just wanna shine, y'all just wanna glisten. Floss, knowing that the soul is still missing. I'm the poetical pastor. Slave to a label, but I own my masters. Still get it poppin' without artists and repertoire. Cause March is a monarch, only modest the A&R. When my brain excels, your train derails. Or everything else should make you feel the clips like Pharrell. You will feel me, you will admire. My struggle, my hustle, my soul, desire. Pages I lust to turn, my pen's the penis, when I write the ink's the sperm. Desire, the fire that ignites the torch that burns. This is not rocket science, this is easy to learn. My mic's the gavel when I talk courts of germs. Respect, even if you was ashes you couldn't earn. I embody antibiotics, you are infected with germs. Rats fatally ill, please get concerned. Players, pick turns to play, get burned. I color commentate the game like Chick Burns. This is the moment of truth for my opponents and liars. Vocals alone evoke the emotion of black choirs. Fire, you don't wanna get burned like Rich Pryor. Move back, who's that there, the live wire? You will feel me, you will admire. My struggle, my hustle, my soul, desire.
Way you listen to radio, iLive Radio.
Saturday Soup on iLive Radio. All the organic goodness you need. Everybody needs some Saturday Soup.
box power shots mixed fly over me. My accurate jabs the met like rotary. Make you notice me, be like, damn, dude's awesome totally. When he rides the baseline like Ginobili, I'm vocally unmatched globally. With the flow, so underground, but mold, public and notary push. In this era of GW Bush, we must load mental ammunition and bust. Thus, I'ma hold you down, I got you. One more repetition, I'ma spot you. This is for my blue collar working, beer guzzling, bootleg, DVD selling, keep hustling, push. If you represent the struggle, then push. Keep the pieces of the puzzle and push. Never let them place the muzzle, just push.
You're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio. iLive Radio.
Saturday Soup on iLive Radio. All the organic goodness you need. Everybody needs some Saturday Soup.
And welcome aboard. If you just locked on, you are in tune to the Saturday Soup Show on iLive Radio UK. My name is DJ Croc from One Nation, here alongside Sims Mode.
Hello.
And we are here from 4 until 6 p.m. this evening. Got to begin by saying big shout out goes out to DJ Deep Sound. Woo-hoo! Can we get DJ Deep Sound on a mic? Can we get you on a mic, bro, for 1 second? Just let me talk to you for a minute, man. Let me talk to you for 1 minute. Talk to you for a minute. The people talk to you for a minute.
Yeah.
All right, cool. You're there. So, Deep Sound.
Yo.
First of all, salute to you, brother. Every week. It's just nonsense in it. It's nonsense.
It is, yeah.
It's nonsense. I don't know where you get the music that you play. But I just want to say the vibes that you bring here every Saturday, 2 to 4, is a nonsense. Wicked. Major salute. Major salute.
Yeah, thank you, man.
We need you out on the road more often, man. You need
definitely
to be out.
You need
bookings. You need to get the promoters on that.
We need you. Do you know what? I'm just not. It's like me now. Yes, I promote and I put on events. I'm not even sure my people are ready for what you're bringing. Really and truly, you're just, your levels are high, bro. Your levels are high. High.
Yeah, so, thank you, man.
Salute. That's all I wanted to say. Salute.
Yeah.
Have you got like a Mixcloud or anything that people can follow you on? You got anything like that?
Yeah, I have. Soundcloud.com/DJ Deep Sound and Mixcloud.com/Jordan-Henry.
Okay. Soundcloud, Deep Sound, Mixcloud, Jordan Henry, yeah?
Yeah.
Alright, cool. Brother, keep doing your thing. Salute.
Salute you.
Next week, 2 till 4, same time, same place, yes?
Definitely.
Alright, we look forward to it. Stay blessed, brother. Peace.
Yeah, please.
There you go, DJ Deep Sound, every Saturday, 2 till 4. If you want to catch up with him outside of the show, then there you've had his links, his SoundCloud and Mixcloud links. I strongly
follow
recommend
him.
You check him out and follow him, alright? DJ Deep Sound. Right, in the building today as well, we have two, not one, but two special guests. We have Samantra in the building.
Hey.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Okay, cool, she's here. She says she's well. So she's going to be doing her monthly feature. If you're a regular to the show, you know she does a monthly feature on health and well-being. She's a wellpreneur, yeah, entrepreneur. She's a wellpreneur. She helps people with their wellness. So she's going to be doing a special feature today. And we're talking about veganism. All right. Yes. Yeah, so there you go. Samantra, you good?
Oh, yeah, I'm good. Sorry. I'm on now.
All right. Cool.
Technical. Thank you.
All right, I think that was my bad. I'll own that. Right, so you're good, yes? And we're going to be talking about veganism today.
Yeah, we're calling it veganish because it's all parameters around alternative eating without meat.
Okay, cool. So does that mean we're talking about vegetarianism as well?
Yeah, it's a whole umbrella of things to think about.
All right, cool. So anybody who's looking to make anybody who is a vegetarian or vegan already, or is interested in that way of life or that way of eating, then stay tuned. We're going to be talking about that and finding out a lot more about it throughout the course of today's show. Also joined by our very first guest DJ to the Saturday Soup show. We welcome DJ A1. DJ A1, yay! Salute, sir. Salute.
Hello. Salute. Hello. Salute. Nah, salute. Thanks for having me. Thanks for having me.
It's our pleasure. Thank you for coming in. So, not only are you today's our very first guest DJ on the show, but you are the newest iLive Radio presenter. Newest iLive member. So welcome aboard. Welcome to iLive Radio, my friend.
Happy to be here, man. Happy
good. So no pressure when you come on later on, yeah, for your first time.
I heard it, bad.
Welcome to iLive Radio. Welcome to Saturday Soup Show. So we're going to be getting you involved and getting you to do a little mix later on, let the people hear what you're about. And I'm going to talk to you a little bit about your journey as a DJ and just about you. Let people find out a bit more about DJ A1. Is that cool?
Yeah, that's cool.
All right, cool. So we got lots lined up between now and 5 o'clock, as well as the gig guide, the news, the sports, and of course, Sims doing the weather. So lots to get through between now and 6 o'clock this evening. All right, kicked off the show with the sounds of Pharoah Monk. I was listening to one of his older albums yesterday, and I thought, you know what, I need to play some of these tunes on today's show. So kicked off the show with a couple of joints from him, one entitled Desire, and then Push featuring Showtime, Melo Makinko, and Tower Power. Right, time is now 4:17. I think that's enough chat. Let's get into some music.
You're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio. iLive Radio. Oh my God.
Saturday Soup on iLive Radio. All the organic goodness you need. Everybody needs some Saturday Soup.
Hey yo, Chris! flash. A team pull up and the other them a flash. Push to the moon, pocket full of cash. When the girl them see we all of them a scream.
Oh my God!
Rap cats, wipe and fire gash. Jump on the paper chases like a 100 meter dash.
Step
up on the stage, we got the works them a fee bash.
Click, 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 click.
I saw the cameras a flash. Daddy, 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 da. Oh, oh. Daddy, 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 da. Daddy, 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 daddy,
daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy,
daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy,
daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy,
daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy,
daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy,
daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy,
daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy, pass in a dark glass, music a blast. No girls want have me feed them breakfast. And a second night, third is a first class. First class, bad mind and haters get embarrassed. Stepping at the future, some living at the past. When we are step, we crush the snake and at the grass. Chris Martin, sing a hook your past.
Me and my past.
Step in, step in, step in.
You know we and the ladies.
Step in, step in, step in. Step in.
In my interview,
step in, step in, step in.
You know a big deal business, baby.
Step in, step in, everything lucky.
Can you hear me? Yeah. When we touch the club, we change the scene. Put away the local car tonight, we're spending green. Mix the Chandon, yes, with the Hennessy. The rub attention, we the gal, them does a free. 24 inches on a very mean machine. Higher than the haters, all the scheme where they must see. They might try to stop the food, but they can never come between. Success will follow we like we are need a family. Love. Daddy, 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 da. Ah, ah. Daddy, 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 da.
Love.
Daddy, 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 da. Ah, ah. Daddy, 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 da. Me and my friend, them will be.
Step in, step in, step in.
You know we and the ladies will be.
Step in.
Sounds of Christopher Martin featuring Busy Signal, track entitled Step In. Time is 4:23. We've got so much to get through on today's show. Remember, if you want to get involved, the studio number is the same as always, 0208-638-8503. The number once again, 0208-638-8503. Or you can holler at us on social media via the Facebook page, either iLive Radio UK page or the Saturday Soup Facebook page. You can also holler at us via Instagram, iLive Radio, and also via the iliveradio.com website, iliveradio.com/iLive-UK. And check out the chat room right there. Sims Mode is in the chat room. All by her lonesome. All on her lonesome.
Yeah, come and say hi.
Yeah, because no one wants to talk to her. So
whatever.
Please go in and say hello to Sims Mode in the chat room on iliveradio.com. Right, let's start talking to Samantra.
Captain, this ship is now under my direction.
So well then them are the champion. Let me tell you this, I will electrocute the sound boy and let them hold them corner.
Right, so time to get speaking to our special guest today, Samantra, who's back with her regular monthly feature on health and well-being. Am I introducing you right? Am I introducing you correctly?
That's great, yeah, thank you.
All right, cool, no worries, no worries. Today we're talking about veganism, veganish.
I'm calling it veganish, like blackish, veganish.
All right, cool. So for those who don't know about blackish, I'm sorry, I can't help you. So veganish, yeah? So we're talking about veganism.
Yeah, and all the permutations. So basically, it ranges from...
Yeah, what is it, first of all? For those that don't know, what is that?
Is vegan?
What is that?
Okay, so there are maybe about 5 types of vegetarianism. Vegan is the most extreme in that you do not have meat, poultry, fish in your diet. No dairy foods or any byproducts. No eggs, no honey, no leather on your feet or on your clothing.
Boy, you can't wear leather. You have to dash with a leather jacket and everything.
Well, if you bought it before you were vegan, then, you know what I mean, just keep it going. But really, no.
Wow. I didn't even realize it went
that's
to that
purest,
extent.
That's the purest.
Okay.
And then you have lacto-veggies. They consume dairies, but no egg. So, yeah, you see. And the lacto-ovo. Ever heard of that?
No.
A lacto-ovo veggie eats eggs and dairy, but has no meat or fish in their diet.
I'm confused already.
I know, innit? So we have people who have nothing to do with animals at all, and then different scales of interaction with eating foods by animals or animals themselves. When I say animals, I mean like meat and fish.
And that comes under vegan?
It comes under the umbrella of vegetarianism.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah, yeah. And plant, they're calling it plant-based diets now, aren't they?
Okay, yeah.
And then we have pesco veggie, who eats fish, so a pescatarian.
Right, yeah.
And a polo veggie, which I've never heard of before.
What are they? They cut out polar bear. They don't eat polar bear.
No polar bears.
They don't wear polar neck jumper.
And no polar neck jumpers in the summertime. But in the wintertime, they like to have chicken.
Oh, really?
Vegetarians with chicken. I mean, yeah, I know. What? I was like, what? Excuse me?
But then how does that come under vegetarian?
Well, I think it's because these categories have come around because people are adopting their diets and their lifestyle. So they may have a vegetarian diet for X percentage of the time. But when they interact with meat, they interact with particular categories of meat or food from animals.
Wow.
I think they just make it up as they go along with it.
Possibly, yeah.
All right, so can we work with a simple definition for the sake of the show,
yeah,
which is
the old school.
People
yeah.
who just don't consume meat?
Well, I'm just talking about really having a plant-based diet. So
okay.
I'm gonna keep it like that, plant-based. Right. Fruits and vegetables, nuts, seeds, beans, rice.
Okay, so for those listeners who are listening right now thinking, boy, I'm not with that. That just sounds dry, dead. I like my meat. I like my beef. I like my curry goat, my jerk chicken, and all of that.
Fried fish and all of that.
What do you say to those listeners saying, boy, that just sounds dead. You just want me to eat pure beans, seeds, like I'm some kind of pigeon or bird or something. Rabbit food. What do you say to them? Because there will be people listening
okay.
and hear that, and that's what's running through their head. So what do you say to them?
Well, that's something I come across quite often. But having an open mind about transitioning or utilizing a plant-based diet as part of your week or part of your month.
Why? What's the benefit of a plant-based diet? Why?
So the benefits to be gained are really from the health perspective on the whole for the individual. But obviously there's the environment. There's the cruelty to the animals. If you want to find out more about that, there are some really explicit videos on YouTube with regards to how animals are treated before they're slaughtered, and that may shift you. There's a global change around this because of sustainability. Many of the countries that are growing the cattle that we're eating as part of our main diet, if you're a meat eater, have to chop down their local, there's deforestation, the way that they have to harvest their own natural produce is put aside so that they can rear cattle for us. And so it's having a massive economic impact on those cultures that are less fortunate than our own. So actually, it's more than just about a choice on I want my meat. It's more about thinking globally about the impact of our own desires, I suppose.
And isn't it the fact that we are now consuming more meat than like 10, 20 years ago or even 30 years ago?
Absolutely. So meat and two veg or whatever, yeah. And the big Sunday dinner would be a treat.
Right.
And a lot of people are eating that amount of meat and all the other trimmings quite often in the week.
Yeah, it's more like every day.
Every day. Yeah. And our bodies... Well, the medical profession are debating the whole, plant-based thing. Mm-hmm. But essentially, research indicates that there are health benefits because you eat less processed food. So that's less fat, less sugar, less salt, which reduces your risk of high blood pressure, heart conditions, diabetes. And it just basically increases your lifespan and the quality of your life.
Okay, all right.
So I must
admit that I've watching. So I have been a meat eater my entire life,
and it's only recently I've started to cut out meat to the point where I don't eat meat very often at all.
Like, why is that? Meat,
and I'm that's what I'm coming to. I'm about to tell you. So you mentioned before those videos on YouTube about how animals were treated and stuff. That's one of the reasons. Uh-huh. Seeing not just the cruelty to the animals, but just some of the unsanitary conditions that the meat is kept in, was one of the things that really first started to turn me off. I don't know why you're laughing. What's funny about that?
I was actually laughing at Sims. Sorry.
Okay, that makes sense because she will lead you astray, so don't follow her. So, yeah, some of the conditions that they keep the meat in was what initially started to turn me off. I was like, well, they really did the meat like that? So that was the first thing that started to turn me off meat. And then starting to learn about the effects on my body was another thing that started to turn me off about meat. Mm-hmm. And then I started to understand or learn more about the benefits health-wise of cutting out meat. So that's basically what influenced my mind, because before that, hearing someone like you say, yeah, go and eat beans and salad and whatever, I wouldn't be trying to hear that. I really wouldn't be trying to hear that. But what made me kind of start to take note and make the changes when I started to see how the meat is processed and treated, that initially started to turn me off. And then learn about the effects on my body, how long meat stays in your body, how long it takes to, you know,
digest
and all of that stuff, and the negative effects on my body. And then learning more about the positive effects of cutting meat out, that's what made me kind of start to make this transition from meat to not having meat.
So you reducing your meat intake, how has it made you feel?
So it's
physically and mentally.
Physically, I feel less sluggish after I eat. Normally, I would eat a big plate of, I don't know, rice, chicken, curry goat, whatever, and I feel really just sluggish and just get the itis kicking. Right. All I want to do is sleep afterwards, basically.
Yeah.
But now, without having a meal without the meat in it, I don't feel like that afterwards. I just feel kind of light and I can still get up and continue working or doing whatever I was doing. I don't feel that big kind of bloatish, sluggish feeling that I had after a big.
Do you feel satisfied though after you eat?
Yes. Yeah. So it's not like I'm eating a smaller portion or I'm eating less. My plate is just as full as it was when I was eating the
with the meat.
Yeah, the meat.
Yeah.
So I do feel just as full. I don't know if I'm confusing the sluggish and bloatish feeling with fullness. You know what I mean? So maybe sometimes I was that bloated feeling. I was like, boy, my stomach feels full and whatever. But really, I just feel bloated.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So my portions are not smaller. My plate is just as full. And I feel just as full when I finish the meal. I just feel like I can still, I don't have to go and sleep. Basically.
Yeah. Nah, I get that. You know? But I think that's something that puts people off, that they feel like
they're not going to be as full.
Like, I know people that say, one guy in particular that says, no meat, no eat. With every meal. It has to be majority meat.
I used to say the same.
I eat meat as well, but not everyday meat.
Mm.
Sometimes I can enjoy a meal that is just salad.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
you know what I mean. So I do get it, but then at the same time, I also enjoy meat as well.
Yeah, listen, don't get me wrong, bro. I miss my meat. I really enjoyed eating meat. I did. I would love. I still love a jerk chicken or a curry goat or oxtail, whatever. I still love all of that. But the knowledge that I have now about what that's doing to my body is what makes me not eat it.
Yeah,
what makes me choose something. It's not that I don't like meat anymore. I still love meat. I love the taste of the jerk and all of that. I love it, love it, love it. I always will. Listen.
It's like you might go and buy some in a minute.
Yo, listen. Even my bacon. Some people talk about that. I've grown up eating that. Love it. Love the taste of it. But it's the knowledge about what it's doing to my body that's making me not eat it. It's not because I don't like eating meat anymore.
Well, here's an interesting fact. Men who reduce their meat intake actually increase their sexual performance. And men who lower the meat intake of their diet also reduce by 60% their risk of prostate cancer.
Wow.
So that's something to think about.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying don't eat meat. What I'm saying is if you choose to eat meat, make sure it's very good quality meat, and also ensure that it's less frequent if you want to have longevity in terms of quality of life and performance.
Because I think with
performance, you know,
I think with red meat takes longer to digest than like eating chicken or fish, right?
I'm not sure about that, but I do know that meat protein takes a very long time to leave your body, and sometimes it doesn't.
So it's like, for me, I would say, like, as you said, don't consume it every day. Maybe you have to kind of go back to the Sunday roast type of thing, or pick a day to have that. But then they have that veganary month.
Yeah, in January after everyone's basically eaten so much meat such an overdrive, and you need, it's literally a month of detoxification. That's what's encouraging, because they know the impact, and January is when businesses want you thinking clearly and working. I think that is another marketing tool for the profit margins.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, all right, so there's all the financial implications of the food industry as well, which I haven't even touched on as yet.
What you have to remember is, particularly in the USA, where they have agricultural farming to the next level, that would be considered obscene, the Food and Drugs Agency oversees both food and drugs. So the USA leads in terms of modifying plants and animals for mass production.
To the point where England, as I understand, and correct me if I'm getting this wrong, but I was watching on the news recently about this, the trade deals trying to be struck up between England and America, the UK and America. Mm-hmm. And one of the issues that America has is that England apparently does not allow poultry into this country from the United States.
Because
it's bleached up on how they treat it.
It's
butch.
I hope they don't do it. I hope it doesn't happen. People are talking like it's going to be a good thing, but we're just going to get bare low quality stuff.
Especially
the meat. The meat is something that worries me, because I still eat it. So I'm not trying to eat no American Trump meat.
Trump meat.
I love
it. Yes, mate. Trump meat.
None of that.
We're going to call it that now. Yeah.
You have veganism, and then you have Trump meat. We love it. DJ A1 bringing new talk to the studio.
Love it.
All right, so we're going to talk more about this throughout the rest of the show. If you want to get involved in this, or you want to have your say or ask a question, studio number is 0208-638-8503. That's 0208-638-8503, or holler at us via the iliveradio.com website in the chat room. Get involved. Right, time is 4:39. Gonna draw a couple more tunes, and then we're gonna talk some more, and then we're gonna get A1 on the ones and twos.
This one's for you.
Right.
This one's for you.
You know I love my remixes.
I think I made it.
One more, J. Cole.
I think I made it. I think I made it, cause I'm always smiling and you're the reason now. Girl, I can't explain it. It's all in the top and I had to get low. I had to get low. I had to get back. I had to report. I had to get facts. Cause you were just that, you that. Girl, you share your truths with me. And I find them true. Amused. You in the booth with me. Dance all the time on a nickel and diamond. I got me a girl, she don't want no diamonds. A daily reminder of how that got. Like, where did you find him? I think I made it. I think I made it, cause I'm always smiling and you're the reason now. Girl, I can't explain it. It's all in the time and I had to get low. I had to get low. I had to get back. I had to report. I had to get facts. Cause you were just that. You that. You share your truths with me. And I find them true. Amused. You in the booth with me. I'm hella faded. Yeah. I'm hella faded. These niggas been hating. I don't know the reason now. Sometimes I feel jaded. They don't see the real me. They only know cold. I had to get back.
I had to resort to turning my back on doing just that, true that. I thought he was through with me, but that wasn't true. The proof, you in the coupe with me. I think I made it, cause I'm always smiling and you're the reason now. Girl, I can't explain it. It's all in the time and I had to get low, I had to get back. I had to report, I had to get facts, cause you were just that, you that. You share your truths with me, and I find the truth. I'm you in the booth with me.
Welcome, if you just joined us, welcome aboard. This is iLive Radio UK. iLive UK, myself, DJ Croc from One Nation, alongside Sims Mode.
Hey.
And this is the Saturday Soup Show. So, Sims, what's been going on in the news this week?
So, this week, Microsoft have invested $1 billion into the Elon Musk-founded artificial intelligence venture. So, basically, they want to put... So, I don't know if you've seen iRobot.
Yes.
So, it's... basically something like that they want to do, to put, like, you know, AI information in your brain.
Oh, into human beings?
Yeah.
Right, okay.
So I'm
how are they intending to achieve that?
The creation of AGI will be the most important technological development in human history, with the potential to shape and trajectory of humanity, said the Open AI CEO, Sam...
whatever.
No, it's Sam Altman.
Sam whatever.
No, not you. No, it's not Sam in the studio. But yeah. I mean, they're not really going into details as such, but the fact that Bill Gates has put money into this, it's kind of scary. Like, we've... you know, like, we was talking... I think not last week, the week before, about you know, with the smartphones and stuff like that. With this coming, I'm just like,
not surprising.
Very scary. Very scary.
All right. Yeah. What else we got? We got a new PM.
Got what?
We got a new PM.
Oh yeah, you know what?
Oh yeah, of all the news you're gonna give.
You know what?
That's the one thing you're not aware of.
I was trying to avoid that actually. But yes, Boris Johnson is your prime minister.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah. Well, he's not anybody's because nobody voted for him.
He's not
a democratically elected prime minister.
No,
neither was Theresa May.
No.
So we're just getting all these prime ministers who nobody, the country don't vote for.
So, but how does that work though?
Politics, UK politics.
But yeah, also he did say that he was going to invest in having 20,000 more police officers on the beat.
Yeah, he has to say that.
Yeah.
Whether he's going to do it or not, he has to say that
because he needs to get people on his side.
He's
been heckled because, you know, there's a lot of people who don't like him and yeah. I was really trying to avoid this because I don't know what he can do. Like the whole shape-shifting of the cabinet and trying to make it more diverse. But even though it's diverse, it doesn't mean that they're caring about the lower class, poor people or whatever. All they're concentrating on is about, you know, cutting taxes for the rich and just putting up taxes for the poor.
Of course.
Plain and simple.
Of course.
But
it's news. We can't have a program and do the news and not say the country has a new prime minister.
You're right. So yeah, he's our new prime minister. He got
switched. Oh, you said he's our. She's switched. She's converted already, mate. He's got you already. He was at 20,000 more police officers talking. You're gonna feel safer in your ends.
You got jokes.
All right. What else?
Also in the news as well, Nicole Murphy. She's the ex of Eddie Murphy. So something surfaced with her kissing a married man. And the guy's name is Antoine Fuqua, I think his name is.
Yeah, I know that name.
Yeah, he directed Training Day and other films. But he's married to Layla Rashan, who was in Boomerang and Harlem Nights. If you don't know who she is, Google her. So, obviously, it surfaced with Nicole Murphy kissing her Layla Rashan's husband. And they're still married, but from what I'm hearing via the Shade Room, they're separated. But my thing is like, if you're going to step out, you might as well just get divorced and then do your thing. But it's like, they're kind of giving Antoine like a little leeway because Layla Rashan has put on weight. She doesn't look like how she looked in the 90s, and obviously Nicole Murphy's all, you know, very athletic body and stuff like that, and she does look good. I ain't gonna lie, she does look good, but that's no excuse.
So what they're saying, because my girl's, she's, what they're saying, because she's slipping,
yeah. Ouch. That's why he's gone.
Is he?
Yeah.
Well, I'm just trying to cut it down to simmer it down to gravy, man, and cut to the chase. Is that what they're saying? They're saying because my girl slipped.
Yeah.
That's what they're giving him a pass.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm not saying that she slipped. I'm just saying, is that what people are saying? I'm trying to clarify what the word is. I don't even check the Shade Room. I don't even deal with these kind of topics, man. I don't even know why we're even talking.
Well, it's been trending. So as you said regarding like Boris Johnson,
we're liking it.
Yeah.
So on the same levels. Then people stepping out as the new PM. All right, cool. So Eddie Murphy's wife has been his ex-wife. If she's his ex-wife, then what's the big deal? She can do what she wants, innit?
Yep. You got it all confused. Nicole Murphy is the ex of Eddie Murphy.
Right.
Now, Nicole Murphy kissed Layla Rashan's husband.
Right.
He's
married to Layla Rashan.
Right, okay, cool.
Anyway, moving on, because he's confused.
I got it now. I just generally don't deal with these Jerry Springer type scenarios. But okay, what's next?
Okay, so ASAP Rocky, US rapper, has been charged with assault in Sweden as he remains in custody. So also this week, Donald Trump Kanye West and Kim Kardashian tried to get involved to basically get him released so he can come back to the US. But Sweden was like, nah, we're not having it. We're going to charge him and he's going to stay in Sweden.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to be an interesting one to see how that plays out.
Well, he's been charged, so it just depends on how long he's going to stay in Sweden.
Nah,
but he's remaining in custody, though.
Nah, because charging is not sentencing to jail. So there's going to be there's the police charge and then there's court and jail and whatever. So I'm sure ASAP Rocky has got a team of lawyers or whatever ready to kind of deal with that case. But it's just interesting how he has been dealt with and treated. I don't know the full ins and outs of the story. I saw a little bit of video footage of the incident. He was in a fight on the street. He said he claims it was self-defense. Mm. You know, it's six of one and half a dozen of the other. But it's just interesting how he's been dealt with.
Well, there's a lot of people on both sides who are saying free ASAP Rocky, but then there's others who are basically like kind of laughing at him because when he made a statement allegedly saying Black Lives Matter is a, you know, a bandwagon and how he don't relate to he can't relate to the people of Ferguson because he doesn't live there, etc, etc.
Now look where he is now.
But look where you are now. Mm. Like when you thought you was going to easily get sent back, you're still there.
Interesting. Yeah. All right, time is 8 minutes to five. The top of the hour, we go for the quick ad break. When we come back on the other side, we're going to talk a bit more to Samantra about this veganish. And also I want to talk to DJ A1, and we're going to get him on the ones and twos, show you what he's about. In the meantime, let's play some more music.
You're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio. iLive Radio.
Saturday Soup on iLive Radio. All the organic goodness you need. Everybody needs some Saturday Soup.
Bossy, bossy, godfather, man a OG, man a half humble, man a bossy. Fling a rag a rhythm like it's all free. Bossy, house on the coast, G. My money so long it doesn't know me. Just looking at my kids like I'm bossy.
Bang, 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 ay.
Hey, yo, Idris, tell them what they're gonna take the piss. One step, you step, or do that turn up in a diss. Body comfortable, I'm in physically fit. I'm in brown and sweet, just like the chocolate.
Yo, Wiley,
them ones don't like me. Cause they done a pussy pretty with the upper
body.
Every man want piece of me. The back of them, a pop of them, a bun weed. Man want wine, but I ain't me, me off a move. Looking for a brother who got hella pounds.
079,
baby, I'ma have my digits out.
Bossy, bossy, godfather, man a OG, man a half humble, man a bossy. Fling a rag a rhythm like it's all free. Bossy, house on the coast, G. My money so long it doesn't know me. Just looking at my kids like I'm bossy.
Hey, yo, Sean.
Hey, so when me sit on the rhythm, baby, gala get with it. Sit on the rhythm, baby, gala get. When me sit on the rhythm, baby, gala get with it. Wind up your body and spin it. Girl, when you bubble, that's a trouble. Why you give me this something? Now turn it around and bring it. You're pressing it back and I know nothing. If you push that button, my girl, don't bother going timid. Once you broke out and fling it. Once your body shaking up to the limit. Once you wild out to wild it. Your ends to the base, step London and mid and edges. Is it?
I came to rap, you know, do my thing. Sabi put me on the gram, you know, remix thing. Full Ty Wiley with the Pacino flow. Godfather part 2, call me De Niro. I came to win, battle me, that's a sin. Disrespect, man, get a slap on the chin. Man, a king, in a top, oh, Larry. Man, a big DJ, Hawks, Megan and Harry. Boss, yeah, man, a boss. I make your girl melt like a toastie. I've been this way someday. And I write for myself, no ghosting.
He's a boy, got money in a bank on. Ready for roll and blaze up this tank on. Got the girls from Jamwa to Hong Kong. The girl, them champion in it.
Bossy, bossy. Godfather, man a OG. Man a half humble, man a bossy. Fling a rag a rhythm like it's so free. Bossy, house on the coast, G. My money so long it doesn't know me. Just looking at my kids like I'm bossy. I fly around the world like I'm bossy. I'm bossy, bossy. Godfather, I'm OG. I'm a
remix for ya, as we like to do. Wiley featuring Steph London, Idris Elba, Sean Paul, remix of Bosey. Time is fast approaching the top of the hour. I just want to get a few more words in from Samantra about this veganish thing. Veganish thing. I'm sorry, that sounds quite dismissive and disrespectful. I apologize. Yeah. I apologize. Don't,
put some respect on it.
Whatever, man. So, Samantra, give us some more info. Veganish.
Okay, what I can tell you is that the trend towards, let's say, plant-based foods is increasing globally. We see an increase. Australia, Canada, New Zealand have made massive shifts. Israel and Austria. Interestingly, Austria released a paper recently saying that actually being a vegan or vegetarian poses greater health risks than being a meat eater. It's interesting that it was posed from this particular country, and there's some controversy behind the funders behind that particular research.
So they're saying that becoming a vegan or a vegetarian is more unhealthy than eating meat?
That's what they're saying in this paper. This particular paper is quite controversial because it goes against the grain of many other papers that have found out individually how diabetes, heart disease, Alzheimer's and dementia are impacted by meat eating because of the generation of mucus within the body.
Yeah.
It takes a long time to process meat. Our digestive tract is not as long as animals in the wild who digest meat. So many doctors, alternative doctors in the field, say that we are either supposed to be eating more fruit or plant-based foods.
See, that's
because
one
our
of the
dietary tract is so short, it really is only for foods that can be digested within a short time frame, and protein, meat protein, is not one of those.
Yeah.
That's one of the things that, you know, I was saying before about what I'd learned about the health impacts of eating meat and whatever that's made me start this journey. That was one of the things I learned about this thing about mucus and how much mucus builds up in the body and how many health problems the body has just because of that. And eating meat was one of the main things that helps to build up mucus in the body, right?
It does, yeah.
Which, that's one of the, another one of the things that kind of helped turn me off meat, just learning that a lot of the problems the body has, including dementia, Alzheimer's, and a whole long list of others, is basically because of the buildup of mucus in the body. And meat and all these other, the dairy products and all the rest of it, all they do is just build up excess amounts of mucus that leads to other health problems.
Well, the mucus is formed because of inflammation. So mucus is there to protect us. That's the body's fighting back against the system being hotter than it needs to. So it's supposed to be dampening and cooling your system down.
But
that only really happens when something is an allergen or an irritant to you.
Mm-hmm.
So if meat causes, and for example, wheat causes a problem, then mucus forms, and that gives you an indication the body's not supposed to be ingesting it.
Okay, fantastic. We have to come back with some more after the break.
You're listening to iLive Radio. Changing the way you listen to radio.
Hey, what's good, y'all? This is Darian Dean, and you are listening to iLive Radio, the home of soul and people that love soul.
Hi, this is Michonne Young, and you're listening to iLive Radio, supporting independent artists from all around the world.
This is Blaze from the DMV on iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to music.
This is Jana Blackwell, the Mistress of Soul, and you're tuned in to iLive Radio, the home of independent music worldwide. iLive Radio is changing the way you listen to radio.
Yes, man, it's me again, Cutbird Wilkinson. You know, I wanted to know about the Saturday soup. You know, you get an iLive Radio, you okay? You know, it's a whole heap of goodness. You get them mixing a little music, them mixing some news, and them mixing some gig guide information. All the hot things were going on in the area, them mixing whole heap of goodness, and then sprinkle it up with some nice mixing and talk, and some guest DJs, and some special guest interviews and things. We love it. Saturday soup, every Saturday, 4 to 6 p.m. iLive UK. Touch!
Hey. Hello and welcome. It's your girl Claude, aka Miss Alge, right here on iLive UK. Be sure to tune into my shows each and every Saturday between the hours of 6 and 8 p.m. My shows are called The Independent Injection because you can expect to hear deep and meaningful, fresh neo and bassline soul, slow jams and gospel mixed with a little bit of nostalgia. I look forward to seeing you then. Bye.
Hey, this is DJ Jarzino. Come and join me each and every Thursday on the Love Freeness Radio Show between 4 and 6 p.m. EST, 9 and 11 GMT. Be sure to tune in, spread the word, and share the link right here each and every Thursday on iLive Radio.
Ready to start your Saturday night? Tune in to the Beats and Bass Show here on iLive Radio with me, DJ Deep Sound. Delve into the sounds of 140, deep dubstep, drum and bass, house, and many genres. Spinning something different every week, featuring special guest DJs and artists. The Beats and Bass Show, weekly, 2 to 4 p.m. UK time, here on iLive Radio. Be there or be square.
What's up, London? This is the Ladies' Choice, DJ Mixmaster Caesar, coming to you straight from the 6 with the Red Planet Mix Show. Every Saturdays, 10 p.m. until midnight, spinning in the best music in hip-hop, R&B, soca, reggae, and top 40, exclusively on iLive UK, changing the way you listen to radio.
You're listening to... iLive Radio. You're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio. iLive Radio.
From the heavens to a head spin to make a song listen. From Kabu after dark, Sugar Hill Spark, found my Neil side when I realized the art was a tic-tac-toe game. Got on my Cobain, I was raised a bullseye amongst long shots with no aim. Face me or face slow pain, but face it, you in the monsoon with a sifter trying to hold rain. Have at it, catch your breath, you asthmatic. It's the wild west, some few have been ass savages. I Doc Holly in a Wyatt Earp Glen. Smithsonian's trying to find my first pen. Stare at me long enough and you'll see why the earth spin. 35 mil depiction, one word description, super.
I'm not the usual one, super.
Watch me do my thing,
super.
skirts unless you're looking through my window from the outskirts. Here's some jewels and some bank teller rules. Don't cash checks without knowing the amount first. Look, pages past the cover of the book. Even the intro might have your info shook. To be clear, things ain't what they appear. The Messiah was on the cross between two crooks.
My to bother me, you want my honesty, keep your distance cause I might decide to leave, evacuate the scene, no kiss by cause I'm not with the PDA, no, told you it'd be this way, so you didn't read the label, don't need a label, you let me lead the way, so I never need to say so, never been faced, no, I'm always ready to stay low, don't put my face on your social, you say I'm so antisocial, I stay low key, it's the way forward. Yeah. Keep up, keep up, keep up, keep up, keep up with me. Keep up, keep up, keep up, keep up, keep up with me. Keep up, keep up, keep up, keep up, keep up with me. Keep up, keep up, keep up, keep up, keep up with me. Can you keep up with me? I can both, so I'm not really that fussy. Said this was news to you. So swiftly, you don't even have a clue what's right in front of you. Sure, taste so sweet. Why have one when I could have two more? I'm not the usual girl. Kiss goodbye to the things you used to. Yeah, you're telling me why they take it so seriously. Don't think that I'll ever make it a thing. You really been getting under my skin. I'm moving solo, cause I've been on my own slow.
Welcome back, Saturday Soup after the ad breaks. My name is DJ Croc from One Nation alongside Sims Mode. And you have been listening to the sounds of our first guest DJ, DJ A1.
Yeah!
How you mean?
Smooth.
It's very smooth. Very, very smooth.
Yeah, that's how I like to do it.
We love it. And that's why you are our newest, not only our first guest on the Saturday Soup show, but our newest newest DJ to iLive UK.
Yeah,
so
come on.
Once again, welcome aboard.
Yeah, thanks for having me. And thanks for the bringing as well.
Listen,
you did bring me in here.
But you told me that you were looking to be on the radio.
It was a huge favour you did me, so I appreciate it.
Nah, it's cool, man. Listen, we real recognise real. Let's just put it like that. Real, recognise real.
I hear that.
So yeah, we're glad to have you here, man. So do you want to give us a track list that we've been playing? Because you've been playing some Ooh. Awesome music right there, man.
Hold up, what was that?
This is part of the issue that us DJs have. We've been digital DJs now. Because when we used to draw out the record box, we knew what we played. Now we have to look back on the laptop.
Initiation by fire.
And see what and see what we play. I have the same thing. So yeah, there were some awesome tracks there. And we're going to need to
get... That was the first one there. That was Fatima, Mind by Fatima. And then... I can't even remember what I've been playing. This is Joe Caulfield. A song called Hair Now. Joe Caulfield, he's a producer. His beats are tight. So,
and yeah, you had a super track. I can't remember who does that.
Oh, that was Versatile.
Yes.
Super by Versatile.
And then Winning. Was it Winning? Winning? What was the track?
Winning? I've got no idea. It's gone now, to be honest. I have no clue.
You know what? I can help you because I shazammed it. Straight. Yeah, Zylo, keep up with me.
Oh yeah, Zylo, keep up with me. That's smooth, that one.
Listen, I don't business.
Yeah, I heard that.
Tune is tune.
Nah, do your thing.
Tune is tune. So, all right. So, interesting journey that you have as a DJ. How long you been DJing?
When did I first start? When did I start doing it professionally?
When did you first start?
I bought my first controller. It must have been August 2017. Yeah, 2017. And then I moved on to turntables maybe a few months after that.
Okay.
And then I did my first club in last June.
So you're new to the game.
I'm fresh to the game. Yeah. I'm fresh to it.
You would never know.
Really?
That's what people in the studio say. You would never know. I certainly did not think that you were that fresh to the game. I thought you'd been doing this for a long time.
He's a rookie.
Nah. Well,
because when I see you touching down at Got Soul, which is where we met, you're really down with the turntablism on actual turntables as well.
Yeah.
So normally, that's not normally guys who are fresh to this that be doing that.
You know what? I like one thing I like about DJing is that the traditionalism that comes with it.
Yeah.
And this is gonna sound strange, but I'm the type of person I like to do the same thing over and over again until I get it right.
Right. Okay.
You know what I mean? And you know, that's what DJing is.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So yeah. When I first took to it, loading up the same track on both sides and then
practicing,
going until I'll get things right.
That's what you do.
That process, you get me.
When you don't even know, you don't even notice that night has become day or day
exactly,
has become night.
Exactly.
We do that. All right. So what's your favorite music that you like to play? Is it this kind of stuff you've been playing here? Do you play other genres or what's your musical repertoire?
I like this sort of stuff. Mm. This is my go-to. Yeah, if I'm allowed to. To do this for a night,
yeah,
in a club,
yeah,
like I'm almost guaranteed to kill it.
Okay.
but then so saying that, I played Afro House out for the first time yesterday, and that was a vibe. So
a blank canvas for you. What would you play if you had the show here, or you're in a set in a club, and the promoter or the station says this is your show, play whatever the hell you want. What would you?
It would probably be a mix of like. Maybe jazz, hip hop, neo soul, Afro house, and then more like producer beaty type stuff like my Kate Renata and Jerome Vandal, that sort of vibe. Then
sweet, you hear
smooth,
these people?
Smooth music.
You hear these people? I hope you're taking notes, people.
Grown people music.
Not even just grown people. I'm hearing Samantha is everything you said. Samantha, mm-hmm. 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 And Sims is over there just nodding her head. Mm-hmm. It's on my right and head nod to the left. On my right, not just. So we're loving that. We love those names you just mentioned. I hope people should be up on those already. If you're not, you don't know, get to know. All right. So we're gonna talk to you a little bit more later on because you do more stuff outside of DJing as well. He's a very interesting guy. He's also a boxer.
Woo!
Yeah.
Turn pro. You gone pro, right?
Yeah, I'm pro.
Hey. Professional boxer in the house. Listen, very interesting guy. So we're going to talk some more about that later in the show as well,
yeah,
all right?
Definitely.
Don't upset him. My name is Kufio. All right. So, Samantra, Veganish.
Yes.
Yeah, have you got some more goodness for us?
Yeah, just if you're going
some
to
more vegan goodness.
Vegan goodness.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can we have some? Can you have jerk vegan?
You can.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Love that.
Or you, is that a menu request?
Yeah, man. Oh. Love that.
Look at that. That's
love
dodgy.
That. Love it. Listen, no, seriously. This is one of the things that has helped me to make. Is helping me to make that transition. Thinking that veg and everything, vegetables and veganism, is just going to taste dry and bland and taste of nothing. So
no.
I what? Can. It's, the way the food is prepared and seasoned has made me much more accepting of vegetarian and vegan food.
Absolutely.
So I think it's a real important thing about, you know, we joke about jerk vegetables and jerk vegan, but it's a real thing that's helped me to make that transition, to know that I can have jerk seasoning, but it doesn't have to be with chicken, or it doesn't have to be with pork, or it doesn't have to be with meat or whatever. You can have jerk veg too.
Yeah, one of the tips that I would say is that home cooking is something that you'd have to start adopting if you want to take a journey, just because you'll know what's inside the dish in terms of the recipe. But
and you're limited when you go out in terms of
you are
options, right?
You are limited. Although I looked at the retail trade in food retail, and there's been something like a 96% increase in vegan food from Just Eat have just record orders now on vegan vegetarian foods. So they're expanding. Walmart have expressed a need for more plant-based foods in their mega stores. So, I mean, it's a globe. I don't think it's a trend. It's not a trend. Everyone says it's not a fad. It is the way that we're going. Mm. But not everybody wants to make that transition fully, completely. And so the tips that I have are to start going in the kitchen, turn on the music, and just play around with the stuff. Literally, food can be bland. Any kind of food could be bland without seasoning. So go out, get some fresh herbs. We don't use a lot of fresh herbs. We use a lot of dry herbs. Go and use some essential oils that are edible. Now you need to make sure that they are and check the bottle. So there are brands that are out there that are like doTERRA. And you can also use spices. Also make sure that you incorporate warming foods, cool herbs.
How do people know what's warming food and cool food?
Well, you kind of know when it goes in your belly, but if you're unsure, there are so many recipes and blogs, etc. online.
Give me two examples of warming food and two examples of cooling food.
So nutmeg is warm. So and turmeric is warming. They're used in curries.
Mm-hmm.
Peppermint is cool. Cucumber is cool. So you can just mess about with things and just try to get different tastes going through your food.
Mm-hmm.
You can use smoothies. So we want raw food more than anything, because that's the most nutritious. And it doesn't mean that it just has to be a piece of cucumber just dry on the plate. You can go into smoothies. That's one of the ways you can take in your raw intake. You could do salads, toss in lots of seeds that have been roasted in the oven maybe, or add some nuts just to add texture.
So about the seasoning. So like how we talked about jerk and veg before, right? So can people essentially prepare or season their veg in the same way they used to season, they would season their meat?
Yes, you can marinate your vegetables anytime. They don't need to marinate as long, and obviously it doesn't cook as long. It doesn't take as long to cook.
You haven't got to leave the chicken.
It's not overnight. No, you don't have to seal it up with cling film or anything like that. So you can literally toss it, let it sit for 20 minutes, and then fling it in the oven if you want to do that. Put it on a griddle, which is on the top grill. Put it in the grill, or essentially you can have it raw, because you don't have to worry about it being raw.
Yeah.
And I would say if you're used to traditional cultural foods and you're transitioning, still use the same recipe book. Just take out the meat and add in maybe beans, or add in rices, or you can do all sorts of interesting things with rice, adding different flavors, and special rice is a Friday night special for a lot of people. Try and do that for yourself.
So experimenting is the thing.
Experimentation is the thing. Everyone's palate is different, but it's nice to have on your plate something a little savory, something a little sweet, something a little cool,
okay.
And mix it up.
So a way to do it is it's not just about cutting like that. It's about transition. Right?
Absolutely. For a lot of people, transition is the best way, because what you're looking for is a lifestyle change.
So you start cutting down. You don't just cut the meat out. You just start cutting down the frequency in which you're eating it until you're almost like weaning yourself off it. Is that right? The best way?
I think for most of us, that would be the best way. Otherwise, there would be cravings.
Yeah.
And then you're just going hard.
Gorge.
And, yeah, gorge completely and then just make yourself sick.
Yeah.
But, you know, after only a few weeks of not intaking meat, you're going to find the difference when you do engage.
Mm.
And you go, oh, yeah, I really fancy that. When you eat it, your body is going to react in the same way that it did before, but in a way that you've never really probably recognized.
Right.
So that's the bloating. Mm. And interestingly, in the Caribbean diaspora, we say itis.
Yeah.
Yeah, when you eat, you get itis and you want to sleep.
Yeah.
Itis is a term in medical field, which means inflammation. So what we literally call it is itis, and that literally is what's happening. The body is overrun.
Okay.
And we need to sleep.
Okay. All right, we're going to get into that a bit more between now and 6 o'clock. We also got the gig guide to give you as well. Before we get into the gig guide, I have to just give you a heads up, which we should have done earlier on in the show, my bad for that, that anyone who was thinking of going to the Curly Treats Hair Festival today, it has been cancelled, all right? It's been cancelled today. I was there this morning, and we were all being turned away because it's been cancelled, apparently. The people who were hired to set the festival up did not do the job, and the festival basically wasn't set up properly. The tents weren't set up, things were not set up. It was like there were live videos being posted on the Curly Treats Instagram, and it kind of looks like someone messaged me and said it's like a fire festival type situation where the tents and the place just wasn't set up properly and it wasn't ready to receive people. So the organizer has been left with no choice.
Well, how much was the ticket?
I don't even know.
£20.
£20.
Yeah.
So the organizer said she was left with no choice, or just on health and safety grounds, to cancel the event.
Mm.
So it's not a good look.
It's sad because the feedback that I've had on that particular event is that it's very well run.
Me too.
Yeah, that's what
I've looked at Curly Tree.
It's been running,
and it looks very, very good. It looks like a great event. So it's very, very surprising and saddening to hear that's happened today. But the fact of the matter is, today's event has been totally cancelled. If you want more information, you can go onto the Curly Treats Instagram. The organizer has posted about 3 or 4 videos showing you exactly what the field looks like and explaining to you why she's had to cancel the event today. And she also said that she's going to be having another event in, she's already organized another event for a winter event. So she's basically going to shift everything from today's event to the winter event. Tickets will still be valid for that event. Stall holders, places will still be valid for that event. So basically everything just gets shifted over to the winter event. So if you're thinking of heading down to the Curly Treats festival today, don't go. It has been cancelled. All right. For more info, go onto the Curly Treats Instagram for more information. And anyone who's bought tickets should have received an email as well letting them know exactly what has happened. So had to just get that out there.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Okay. A1, you got some more tunes for us, sir?
Yeah, well, plenty, man.
Keep it smooth. Right, man. Keep it smooth.
Let's go.
Oh,
let's
maybe
go.
Afro.
Yeah. Afro?
Yeah.
Afro. All right. I'll see what I can do. I'll see what I can do. You're putting me
listen,
on the spot.
Listen, oh. She's a guest as well, you know. You don't need to follow her.
I'm a special guest.
You don't need to follow her. All right, here we go. DJ A1, Saturday Soup.
You gave me a kiss all night.
she ain't me cliche. Cheapskate, love the fucking deep fate. Said she never had a daddy, I ain't used to be impatient. Got a lot of spite, but that pussy tight, I'ma wait. I can hold a lot of money, she can hold a lot of grudges. I buy a lot of weed and lazy tea like I don't give a fuck. I guess I'm too young for love. Must be love, too young for love. Must be drugs, too young for love. Must be love, too young for love. Must be drugs, too young for love.
DJ A1 in session, iLive UK. Loving it, loving it, loving it, loving it.
It's so smooth, they dimmed the lights.
It's so smooth, Jarzino came in and just dimmed the lights. That's how smooth it was. This room has never felt so smooth.
Hey, it's a vibe, man.
Hey.
No, 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 you're guessing me up.
No, for real. We have never had these lights on before, bro. We have never, ever had these lights on before on this show. Not on this show. So that's you.
All right, cool. That's the A1 effect.
All right, do you want to let the people know what you just played? What you just played?
That was, you know, I'm actually prepared because I took down the history this time. That was, the first one was, that was Sade Kiss of Life, the Kitchen Art remix. And then that second one there, that was Last Kiss by Overdose. Cool. And this here in the background, this is
another Catronada.
Flume holding on, Catronada remix.
Yes. All right, so Sims, what else we got between now and top of the hour? We've got 30 minutes left.
Well, this week, those who went to Alton Towers basically got stuck on the Smiler ride. The same ride from how many years ago that obviously some people got injured badly. Got stuck, and I'm thinking, like, shouldn't they just like allow this Smiler and just put something else there,
break it down like Lego?
Yeah, exactly, because like that's the second time, and obviously it's taken a few years for them to get back to being one of the best theme parks.
I didn't even know Alton Towers was still open.
Well, you're just
Yeah, I have more important things to do. Yeah, that's right. Okay. I didn't even know it was still open.
Okay, well, yeah.
Smiler ride. So this has happened before on the Smiler ride.
Yeah, so a few years ago.
What is this, a roller coaster?
Yeah, it's bonkers.
I've been telling people for years about these roller coasters, man.
I'm a thrill seeker, so...
Yeah, go on it
I
then.
I mean, what?
Go on it then. You'll get all the thrills of your life when you get stuck up there.
I won't get stuck up there. You're just... Anyway. So,
you want to kiss your teeth, don't you?
I'm not. I'm going to be nice.
Well held.
But yeah, like, it's just, I think they just need to either just demolish it and put something else there, because clearly that ride ain't the one. It's like a curse or something.
It's an upside down Smile.
But it's a good ride to look at, because I've been there when, obviously, when the tragedy happened. We did go I went with a friend of mine, but wasn't able to go on it. But yeah, they just need to like scrap that and start over.
Okay.
Yeah.
So Legoland then for everyone. Legoland.
No, not me. No, oh, Fort oh. Park.
Okay.
Fort Park. So, you know, as every week I do the weather.
I look forward to the
weather. And, you know, this week has been a heat wave. It was 38.7 on Wednesday, which is like the hottest temperature in history. So, yeah. But obviously, the weather for Saturday and going forward, outbreaks of heavy rain across the western Scotland, North East Wales and England away from the southwest, but becoming drier and brighter in the northeast later. Sunny spells and isolated showers elsewhere. Outlook for Sunday to Tuesday, heavy rain continuing across the northern and
stop.
So basically it's just going to rain, but it will be warm. The weather will be warm. But that's what you've got to look forward to. I just can't believe, like,
it was so quick.
I don't trust English weather, because it's like you will get a few days and everybody's, I've just got a feeling everybody's put away their winter coats and raincoats, and
people have gone out shopping, all this
flip flops and salad, sandals and stuff like that, and then now we're just dropped back down to 17 Celsius.
I know, but wearing, it's humid as well, though.
But it is, yeah, because of the heat.
Yeah.
Because of the heat. But, yeah, so that's your weather. Also, let me do the birthdays. So if it's your birthday today, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
And you share it with Triple H, the wrestler. He's 50 years old. Tory Lanez, rapper, 27 years old. Winnie Harlow, who is a model. She's 25 years old. And Maya Rudolph, the daughter of Minnie Riperton, is a TV actress. She's 47 years old today. So if it's your birthday, happy birthday once again.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to ya.
Yeah, get the remix
happy
in.
Happy birthday.
Go, girl.
Don't get me started, you know. Start singing away. What is the time? 5:34. You're listening to iLive UK. DJ Croc, what are you saying?
I am saying that time is against us today, man.
I know,
time,
right?
Time is really against us.
So I know I was meant to do the gig guide, but I'll just give out like two or three of them.
All right.
And the rest has been posted up on the Saturday Soup page on Facebook. So if you go to Facebook, type in Saturday Soup, like the page, share the page, and then you can see all the gig guide on there, and that will be going out every week. But first off, Soulfest Lounge UK.
Ooh.
Thursday 26th of September at the Hideaway, Streatham, London. Shayla Prosper and Ray Robinson are your artists for the night, hosted by Shaq D.
Don't you usually say your...
Yeah, but you always correct me, so what's the point?
All right then. I'll say, like, you know... Anyway.
All right.
No.
Do it again.
Hosted by Shaq D.
Shaq D!
That was worth coming back for, come on.
DJs on the night. James Kismetit Len from Raw Soul. Gary Van Du... Oh, got it. I got that, yeah. Gary Van Der Bush from Starpoint. And Peter Smedley from Solar. Tickets via www.hideawaylive.co.uk/Soulfest Lounge UK. Also, you've got your Got Soul every Sunday at South Place Hotel in Moorgate. Do you know who's playing this Sunday?
I don't, but I can tell you. But yeah, each and every Sunday, South Place Hotel in Moorgate, Got Soul, the UK's only weekly Neo Soul Lounge, now in its 8th year. And it's always on every week from 6 until midnight. This Sunday features GNC and Dave Knight.
Nice. And then you've got your One Nation next week, right?
Yes, next week, Friday. And the first Friday of every month is One Nation's Remix Friday. Upstairs at the Ritzy in Brixton, the Ritzy Cinema in Brixton. We're there from 8 p.m. until 2 o'clock in the morning. And next week, Friday, is all about Jamaican Independence Special. August is the month where we do Jamaican Independence Celebration. So we'll be playing our part next week, Friday, at One Nation, having our special Jamaican Independence Celebration as part of Remix Friday. Our special guests will be the Just Vibes crew.
Nice.
In Yemen.
They're Trini, aren't they?
Yes, but they represent the entire Caribbean. They don't just represent Trini.
Just chicken.
Yeah. So for all their events,
can you drop me a few Dominican tracks?
Yeah, I'm sure we can. So you'll notice at every Just Vibes event that they do, they have a stream of flags throughout every single venue that they play at, and it's every flag in the Caribbean.
You reckon?
What do you mean? I reckon it's not a question. I'm telling you,
okay.
That's what they do.
All right, because you know, usually they miss out. They miss out. Some.
They carry the flags with them, and you will see they put them all up on the scene everywhere they play. Whether they play at Pot Brixton, Dogstar, wherever, okay. They have all the flags.
I'm gonna check it. I'm gonna check it out. Don't worry.
Yeah, see, there's always someone. There's always gonna be someone.
Why is my flag not up there?
Well,
this is the thing, because usually they don't have Montserrat's flag up there, and it should be up
there's
there.
There's always somebody that's going to point out and say, you know what, that's not there, or my flag's not there. The point is, they represent the Caribbean. They don't just represent one island. Right? Show me somewhere else where they have all the flags
so
of the Caribbean
take down
up in the venue.
Jamaican flag everywhere.
Show me somewhere where they do that. And plus, this is Jamaican independence. Why do we have to have Montserrat flag up? When it's Jamaican independence. Why does Montserrat come into our team when it's Jamaican independence?
Okay.
Thank you. So, Friday, Remix Friday. No, don't bother with that now. Because you come with your Trini, Dominique, and she come with Montserrat. Everyone needs to come in on our team. And it's a Jamaican independence thing.
Do they have Nigerian flag there?
Do you know what I mean? Let's just make it every independence, every country, every nation independence.
Let's have a diaspora flag.
Do you know what I mean?
Flag.
It's like Black History Month. It's just going to be every History Month. Let's just dilute the team. They don't exist no more. So Friday, August the 2nd, upstairs at the Ritz in Brixton, yeah, One Nation Remix Friday, Jamaican independence.
That was so easy though, Sims, wasn't it?
Celebrations.
Right.
All right. Myself, DJ Croc, as your host and resident, and the Just Vibes crew will be there representing the Soca and Dancehall squads. All right.
Oh,
so you know
Soca,
the Just
yeah?
Vibes by Just Vibes by name, Just Vibes by nature. So make sure you're there. Tickets are only £5 on Eventbrite. More on the door.
I'll give you one more gig. Dead Prez, Havoc from Mobb Deep, Loki, 47 Soul and DJ Snuff will be at the Electric in Brixton Friday the 16th of August, hosted by Humanity for Palestine. Tickets are you can get your tickets via www.ticketweb.uk. But for the rest of the gig guide, please go to
Hold on,
I've got to give one more
because it's tonight. Neo Soul Collective happens tonight at Exquisite. That's at 12 Station Rise in West Norwood, SE27 9BW. That's Neo Soul Collective, happens tonight at Exquisite in West Norwood. On the bill again, James KMT Leng, Tony T, DJ Marvelous, Mr. Lambert, Nice and Rugged Crystal, and MC Dodge and De Niro. That's tonight, Neo Soul Collective at the Exquisite Lounge, 12 Station Rise, West Norwood, London, SE27 9BW. For the rest of the gigs, check the Saturday Soup Facebook page. That's it for now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right. Do you know what? Enough chat. A1, give us some redeem.
Let me testify, I swear, I'm in the right.
right place at the right time with the right girl.
DJ A1 in session. So yes, my name is DJ Croc, but you'll be listening to the sounds of DJ A1, our very special guest DJ for today's show and the newest presenter to iLive UK. Yeah, this is how he gets down. Bruv, you're going to get a One Nation call up real soon. I'm telling you that. Real soon. Real soon.
Nah, I'd love to do that, man. I'd love to be there real soon.
I would call you up next Friday, but I need to know what your... It's Jamaican independence. I need to know how you can handle that. But you're definitely going to get a call up real soon.
Yeah, yeah.
So look out for DJ A1 on iLive UK real soon. All right, if you like this stuff, then follow him in the meantime. You got a SoundCloud and that people can follow you at?
All the links are through my Instagram.
Okay.
Which is AWAN_spins. So that's SPINS. AWAN_SPINS.
Okay, A1_spins. Cool. And all your links are
from
there.
All the links are on there.
Fantastic. Follow this guy. If you like his tunes, like as much as we do, follow this brother. So look at Sam. She's getting out her phone right now and she's following. Look, she's making a note. This is how we like it. AWAN_spin. SPIN. Yeah. All right. Okay, Samantra.
Yes, hi.
Just rounding off what we've been talking about, the veganish. Have you got any links to forward to be anything you want to kind of round off with this as a sort of closing note? And then we get into links that people can follow to get more information.
Yes. What I'd say is that this really wasn't a talk that we wanted to preach to people.
Mm-hmm.
We just wanted to say that thinking about expanding your vegetarian or plant-based foods is the way forwards for your health and for the planet as a whole, that sometimes people take the step towards being vegan and buy processed foods, right, Sims?
Right, yeah. So I, even though I'm a vegetarian, I used to buy meat replacement meals. I won't mention any of the names, but you should know.
What's that like? Like corn and stuff like that?
yeah, that kind of stuff.
Is corn really that bad?
Well, if you read the ingredients, there's some things that are just shouldn't be there.
Such but as?
I can't remember the word, the long name of them. Like, if you go onto any, just type in the product, the mince one, and read the ingredients. And then some of the stuff just doesn't sound like it's natural anyway. So I decided to stop using that. And instead, so if I wanted a veggie burger, instead of me buying it ready-made from the freezer, I would just make my own. And by making your own, obviously you're using the ingredients that is what you have there in front of you, and you're not adding all these other chemicals or whatever they are into it. And it even tastes better.
Yeah.
All right. So it's corn, but all right. So I hear all of that. But for the regular person who is not down, is just starting, or even just considering
but
this journey,
we
talked about this being a process. So for someone who maybe wants to transition over and can't do it just hard like that, is corn a stepping stone to transition?
No, but what you have to do, you have to go back to basics. Like, you need to start learning how to enjoy cooking food and using ingredients instead of just going for that option. Because the same way you can get a pack of mints, add your little seasoning to it to make your meatballs or your hamburgers and stuff like that, is the same process you can do without the meat. You just have to replace it, whether it's with mushrooms or with red kidney beans, anything like that, and just add your own seasoning, your fresh herbs.
I hear that. I keep thinking about the people who don't even do that, people who just don't cook. You know, and I know people should be cooking more at home, but I'm thinking about those people who are getting people from where they're at. Not necessarily where we want them to be, from where they're at. So if you're someone who's just don't cook, for whatever reason, whether it's your busy lifestyle or laziness or whatever it is, or nobody taught you to cook, whatever, you know, I'm just thinking of where can they start from. You know, maybe going out and buying all the stuff and cooking is not the starting point for them. Maybe it's just somewhere else up the road.
I think it should be. I think that's where it needs to start, because that's how you learn to cook food. Mm-hmm. And then it can be just the basic thing of getting those ingredients and even making like a veggie spaghetti bolognese type of thing.
Yeah, I think that...
Yeah, go ahead.
I was going to say that I think that for some, because it is a journey, that maybe getting those vegetarian alternative meat-free dishes is a choice that they have to work into their lifestyle so that they're eating meat less. But that's just part of the process, to understand that really engaging in cooking whole food and cooking from plant-based foods that haven't been processed is the best way forward. So yeah, some people will need stepping stones. Other people would just be like, okay, I'm in the kitchen, I'll do that.
That's what I was saying. Yeah, that's an end final destination point. But you know, there are some people who might just need that as a stepping stone.
Absolutely.
They're just, by doing that, they're eating, like you said, they're eating less meat, and then they're transitioning.
But what I would say is that Sims is right. The ingredients within some of those processed foods, I no longer eat those foods either. Mm. But both Sims and I have taken steps towards where we are now by using those foods. So,
and there's a lot of advertising that people are still being bombarded with, saying that corn is good. So you got, you're fighting against that as well. people seeing all that stuff on TV, corn is great. Corn is healthy alternative.
Is all corn equal though? Like, because obviously different people are making it now. So one person, you know what I mean? In the same way that meat can all be, I guess, you have processed meat and then you have actual real, like, grass-fed steak. You know what I mean? Organic steak. Like, there's a big difference. So perhaps there's a different... I'm not sure.
I would definitely say reading the labels is the place to start anyway. So if there's something on there that you cannot pronounce yet, that doesn't sound like it was grown out of the soil, then it was probably grown in a lab.
Sounds like false advertising, because they keep saying, quote, healthy alternative to meat. And now we're learning that it's actually not that
healthy. I don't like it. I don't like it at all.
I don't like it either, to be honest. I don't like it.
I think if you give up meat, then you shouldn't be eating things that now resemble meat.
Yeah, or is even more artificial or more fake than the meat you eaten before.
I think it'd probably be better to just stick with just meat then, if you're going to exchange it for a processed substitute. I don't know. I'm just guessing.
Excuse me. You know what? Like you said, it's a journey. With me, I didn't just come straight off meat. I went from just regular any meat to then organic meat or organic dairy products to then the next phase was coming off the meat and dairy products altogether. Excuse me. So
an 80-20 rule is also good. Like, you know, if you have to have those processed bits, but you know, 80% of your week is that you're home cooking, and maybe you have leftovers, and then you're, you know, recycling up and or whatever, or you've got a big bowl of salad ready that can last you, and you've sealed it, you know, airtight. It doesn't have to be time consuming. I think people make the process seem time consuming.
That's another positive with the vegan cooking, is that it doesn't take so long to cook. When you cook meat, you got to be that chicken's got to be stewing, or the goat's got to be stewing for.
How about you've got to like clean the
all
meat
of that, all of that. All of that. It's right. It's a much longer time. Yeah. It's a lot quicker to cook vegan or vegetarian meals than it is to cook meat meals. And the other thing I wanted to throw in there before we finish the show is that my body's a lot healthier from cutting out meat and dairy. Mm-hmm. There were health issues I had that I no longer have anymore because of the way that I've changed my diet. So that's something I just can't stress enough. There were health problems I had, like some quite serious, that I no longer suffer from just because of a change in my diet.
Right.
That's real talk. Cutting out meat, cutting out dairy, and there are certain things I just do not suffer from anymore within my diet. Mm-hmm. Just much healthier.
There are things that you should consider, though. You need to be informed and understand different food groups so that you get enough protein, which is important because that's the repair and regeneration of cells. Mm-hmm. And if you don't get enough protein, then the body will try to upcycle from within you.
So that's some of the good stuff that you could get from meat. We need to try and get it from a different sort of like protein.
Yeah, the proteins. So, for example, rice and peas are not meats, but together combined they are equivalent to, say, having meat. It's a whole protein. So protein is made up of like 22 blocks, like Lego blocks. So, you know, you've got to try and find all those Lego blocks to fit together, and you can find combination foods. You can Google combination protein plant-based foods and find out the list.
Okay, and ways, as you talk about Googling, do you have any other useful links for people to find out more information about this, or links to yourself?
Yeah, I think that if you're going to take a journey to expanding plant-based diet, then please do some research. Go onto some sites like Vegan Society or livestrong.com or foodrevolution.org. They have very useful, and there are blogs available. So there's some nutritionists out there that can give you advice. In terms of contacting me as a holistic wellness coach, you can contact me via my Instagram. My name there is YinYangSamantra. So that's YinYangSamantra.
Yin Yang Samantra.
Yin Yang Samantra.
And you mentioned something about doTERRA earlier on. What's the doTERRA? You're talking about oils or something.
So there are some high quality essential oils that have the potency to heal or provide natural solutions and support to the body. Mm-hmm. And you can also use them in your foods because they are so potent, the flavoring is enhancing your raw food. So again, if you want to find out more, please contact me via Gmail, and that will be yinyangsamantra@gmail.com.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
All that info, all that goodness.
That's the Saturday Soup Show.
All the organic goodness you
all
need.
The organic. West Country, all the organic.
Right, fantastic. Thank you to everyone who has logged on to today's show. We hope you've enjoyed it. We hope you found it useful, informative, helpful, as well as enjoyable. Thank you to our very special guest DJ, our very first guest DJ, DJ A1.
Thank you.
Love the tunes, bro. Nah, thank you very
yourself,
much.
Man, big up yourself. It's a good thing you lot are doing, man. And thank you very much for having me. Thank you
thank
very,
you.
Very, very,
look
very
forward
much.
To hearing you. Much more
yeah,
of
yeah,
you
definitely.
On
that. We'll do this again, man. We'll do this again. And then you come on my show. And
yay. Hey! That's all of us, right?
Yeah, of course.
No, that's just me. He said just me.
Oh, okay. Like that.
Thank you, Sims Mode.
Woo!
Deep Sound has come back in the building to get a another salutation because he hears we're bigging up everybody.
Big up,
so
big up, big up.
Big up, DJ Deep Sound. All right. DJ Claude, a.k.a. Miss Ouch, is up next with the Independent Injection, giving you nothing but the best in independent soul music from 6 p.m. till 8 p.m. So make sure you keep it locked right here, iLive UK. Well, we're going to send you out with the sounds of DJ A1.
Yes.
All right. Woo. We'll be back next week, same time. Peace.
Peace.
Chiclete, nossa, gostava como a Nugala. Me dá de volta, vai. Volta todos os dias, come no seu trabalho. Cavaleiro, eu sou o seu cavalo, vai. Primeiro me abraça e beija minha careca. Essa noite você vai ser minha boneca. Vamos fazer coisa doida, mas só para a beleza. Essa noite você vai ser minha boneca. Eu dou na hora, eu dou, uma vez entra, outra fora, eu dou na hora, agora já vou dar de volta quando acabo. Eu pergunto pra Deus, uma gata, uma mulher, ele falou valeu.